House Orlock is an industrial superpower known as the House of Iron, and its gangers are renowned for their close bonds and personal loyalty to one another. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint a House Orlock ganger in the colour scheme of the Sump Dogs, which is the colour scheme you can see on the box. And we're going to be using Jackson for our example, but by following the methods and techniques we're going to show you in this video, you'll be able to paint your entire gang. So without further ado, let's get started. As with any Citadel miniature, the first step of painting your model is to undercoat it. And for this miniature, I've chosen to go for Mechanica Standard Grey Spray, which you can see just here. Now, the reason I've chosen this colour is that it's an excellent starting point for all the colours we're going to be using on this model. And the first one is Thunderhawk Blue. Now, as always, remember to give all your paints a really good shake before you use each colour. And I'm going to be applying this one using a medium base brush. Now, throughout this video, you're going to see I use a palette, and I recommend you do the same, because what you do is get some of this paint onto the palette. The reason for it is it gives me much more control over the paint, and it allows me to thin it down with a little bit of water. You don't need much, but by mixing water in like this, what happens is the paint thins down and will dry smoother on your miniature. It'll go a little bit further as well, and you can use the palette to make sure your brush isn't overloaded, so this way you've got lots of control over it. And once you've done that, all you've got to do is start painting the shirt of your Orlock ganger. So what we're looking to do is to paint in this detail here. At this point, don't worry about being too neat. Don't worry about catching the details as you apply it. Try and keep it to a minimum, but we will be painting in other details as we go. So we'll be neatening up as we progress further on the miniature. Once you've finished base coating the shirt, you're then ready to move on to applying the next colour, and this is going to be Dawnstone. Now this colour is going to be to start setting up all the areas that later on are going to be white, and we're going to be applying this using a medium layer brush because a lot of these details are quite small, so you need much more control than you had previously for them. So pop the paint onto your palette, and again add a little bit of water in there to thin it down so it's nice and smooth, and flowing about this sort of consistency, you see it's running really easily off my brush. And what we need to do now is just start picking out all the details that later we want to be white. So the first of these is going to be the collar just up here. You can see it's quite a fine detail, and I need to be careful of that blue shirt as I apply it, so just really taking my time painting that in. But we also need to paint the bandana as well. Now this one is beneath a little leather strap there for the goggles, so I just need to paint either side of that, but we've also got this bit sticking out of the side as well. And the other part that later on is going to be white is the loincloth down here, so be sure to pick out this part too. Now on a larger flat surface like this, you might find the Dawnstone's a little bit transparent as you apply it. And if it is, don't worry about it. Just let this first coat dry and then apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way. Once you've finished applying Dawnstone, we're then ready to move on to the next colour. Now the next one's going to be Dryad Bark, and this is for all the brown leather details in the miniature. So really, we're looking at straps. And I'm going to be applying this mostly with a medium layer brush once again, but it's a good idea to have a small layer brush on hand now because some of these details are very small and you might need just a little bit more focus with the finer bristles to get to those parts. But either way, what you need to do is again get your paint on your palette and thin down so it's nice and smooth. To about this kind of point here, you can see it's quite runny. And making sure my brush isn't overloaded, all I need to do now is start picking out these details. And the straps we're looking at are, for example, like this one running across the chest here. All I'm going to do is just carefully start painting it in, now being really careful around those details that we've already base coated. So in this case, just being careful around the shirt there. The other parts you'll want to pick out at this stage are the leather band we've got going, holding the goggles on around the head, so just there. And also you want to paint any bits of stowage. So for example, this little pack we've got here, you want to base coat these details too. And with that colour applied, we've now base coated the leather. And now we're ready to move on to applying the next base coat. And in fact, the next three base coats all use the same technique as what we've been showing you, so we're going to run through those quickly for you now. First of all, we need a Baden Black to base coat all the black details, and then we're going to move on to Lead Belcher for all the silver details. Finally, we're going to need Baylor Brown, and this is going to be for our Orlock Ganger's hair. But first of all, we're going to be applying a Baden Black, and I'm going to start out with my medium base brush once more, but have those smaller layer brushes on hand because you will need them during this stage. There are quite a few details we need to base coat with this colour, and for all of them, as always, use your palette to get your paint ready, then just take your time picking these parts out. So what we're going to do is start out by base coating the trousers, and you can see what I mean here about neatness. As I start applying it, I'm just going to be really careful as I get behind the loincloth just there. And the details we're looking at base coating here are the trousers and also the vest. We need to paint all the armour as well, and also the casing on the weapon. And also, don't forget to base coat the boots at this stage as well. Once you've finished base coating all the black details, you're then ready for all the silver details. And for this, we need Lead Belcher, and you're looking at details such as the magazine on the gun, along with some smaller elements on it, such as just along here on the barrels. But also, we need to look out for some armour plates as well. For example, the one that we got just down here on the leg. And then finally, base coat the hair and the moustache using Baylor Brown. Now that we've finished applying those base coats, we're ready to add some shade to the miniature. And for this, we're going to use null oil. Now, when you're using shade, you don't need to add any water to it, but I still recommend you use your palette because doing so allows you to gauge exactly how much of this you're applying at once. And sometimes you won't want to overdo it, but for this example, we want to get a good amount first of all. If you want to begin with quite a lot on your brush. So get a good puddle like that, load your brush up, and it's a medium shade brush I'm using here. And all you do is start applying it all over your miniature like this, and you'll see the shade runs into all the recessed detail and gives those colours lots of depth. Now, as you're applying this, you will find that the shade tends to run down towards the bottom of the miniature and will start to collect in some details. For example, you can see if I paint quite a bit on just there on the loincloth, you can see I get a large amount collecting in that recess there. When you see that happening, don't worry about it. Just use your brush just to move the excess paint away like that so it doesn't blob up too much there. Now, aside from that, you will need to give the miniature plenty of time to dry before you move on to the next step. Around about half an hour will be fine for a miniature of this size. Once the shade's completely dry, you're ready to move on to painting in the next area of detail, and this is going to be his skin. Now, the first colour that we need for this is Bugman's Glow, and this I'm going to be applying with my small layer brush. And as we paint this on, you just need to be careful because we need to paint around his moustache now. So, as always, make sure your paint's thin down and ready, but you really must make sure that you don't overload your brush here so you have that control with it. And once you're ready, all you've got to do then is start picking this detail out. So as you can see, just here, see the moustache, I just need to be really careful as I'm painting around it. Now if you do make any mistakes and you do catch it, don't worry about it. Just go back to Baylor Brown and neaten it up before you continue. But another bit of skin that you need to watch out for, which is easy to miss, is that he's actually wearing fingerless gloves. So you just need to paint the end of them just down here like this. Once you've finished base coating the flesh, you're then ready to apply some shade to it. And this time we're going to use Reichlin Flesh Shade, but we don't need very much, so I'm going to still be using my small airbrush to apply it, and definitely using that palette this time, just to make sure the brush isn't overloaded with it. So you don't need all that much, but once you've got the right amount on your brush, all you've got to do is start painting this onto the skin, once again just being really careful around the moustache. So try and avoid getting the shade on that detail, just like this. The shade is now completely dry, and you can see once again that it's settled nicely in all the recessed detail and really helped to bring out the features of the skin. But what we need to do now is bring those features out even further by applying a layer, and for this we need Cadian Flesh Tone. Now I'm going to be applying this again using my small layer brush, and what we need to do here is be very selective about exactly which parts we pick out. So you must thin your paint down to help out with this control here, and also make sure your brush isn't overloaded. The really important thing is to get that fine tip on the brush, so just twist the bristles like this to bring them to a nice point. And then what you need to do is start applying this paint to most of the skin, but avoiding the recessed detail where the shade settled. So for example, if we look at the face, the really obvious one is the eye. So what I'm going to do is just paint this down the centre of the nose there like that, and down to the side, just avoiding that recess there where it meets the rest of the face there. I'm, however, going to start painting on the cheeks just underneath the eye, just there, and across the top of the brow there like that. So you can see by doing this, I'm just really bringing out the features even more. With that layer complete, we're now ready for the last step of painting the flesh, and that is to add a highlight of Kislev Flesh. Now for this we need the small layer brush again, and what we're looking to do now is pick out the most prominent features of the flesh, so all the sharpest features really. So as always, make sure you paint thin down, but it's very important here you get that fine tip on the brush because it's only small parts we're going to be painting now. So once you're ready, the kind of things we're looking at are areas such as the bridge of the nose, for example. So what I'm going to do is just carefully paint a line of this colour just running down the very middle there like that. But another sharp feature would be the brow, so we want to go along there too, so just very carefully like that. We've also got the cheekbone to do, so just across there, and we also want to pick out the chin as well. So you see it's all these sharper features just being really neat just to get them like that. And there we are, the skin is complete, and now we're ready to move on to the next step, which is to revisit some of the details that we have on the rest of the body. Now that null oil shade, whilst it did give lots of depth to the miniature, it did darken down a lot of the colours, so what we need to do now is apply a layer of a few colours to brighten them back up again before we highlight them. So first of all, we're going to go back to Thunderhawk Blue as a layer on the shirt, and then we're going to go back to Baylor Brown to layer the hair. Finally, we're going to add a new colour, which is Ulthurn Grey, and this is to layer all the bits of fabric that are later going to be white. But first of all, we need Thunderhawk Blue, and I'm going for my medium layer brush to apply this, but you might want to have a small layer brush on hand for this for some of the finer details. And as always, get your paint ready by adding a bit of water to do it. And what we're looking to do this time with Thunderhawk Blue is apply it to the same areas, but not over the entire area. So if I start on the centre of the shirt, what I'm looking for is areas where the shade settled the most, so I've got it around the edges mostly on this part. And what I'm going to do is apply this colour to the middle like this, leaving that darker line then going around the outside to give some nice shading. Same will be true on the sleeves here, when I'm looking for the creases, you can see the shade settled in the middle there. So as I apply this colour, I'm going to just leave those parts darker there like that. Next, we're going to return to Baylor Brown to apply this as a layer to the hair. So again, we're looking to paint this onto the raised surfaces, but avoiding those recessed details where the shade settled. And finally, we're ready to add a layer of Ulthuan Grey to all the fabric parts that are going to be white. So for example, the loincloth we've got down here, what I'm going to do is start applying this colour like this, following the folds of the fabric. So I'm aiming for the raised areas like this, again avoiding those recessed details to leave them darker. You can see this colour is a little bit transparent, so I will be applying two thin coats of this one. With those layers applied, we're now ready to move on to highlighting all these details. And the first of these is going to be the blue shirt. And for this, the colour we need is Fenrisian Grey. Now I'm going to be applying this colour using my small airbrush throughout this time, and what we're looking to do is, like when we're highlighting the skin, pick out all the most defined, sharpest features of the fabric. So you just need to get your paint ready as always, but that fine tip on your brush is important. Thin it down just so that it's flowing really smoothly and there's no resistance with it. And once you're ready, you're just looking for those edges. So for example, if I take a look at the sleeve just here, you can see we've got all the creases around the edge here. So what I'm going to do is look for the very tops of these parts, and also the edges, and just run a line of this colour along them like this. And there we are, the blue shirt is complete, and we can move on to highlighting the next detail, which is going to be all the white fabric. Now for this, the colour we need is White Scar, and I'm going to be applying it using the small layer brush again. And we're going to be following the same technique as what we did previously, following all those most raised areas. But because some of this white fabric is quite smooth, there's certain points you need to pick out here, which we'll show you shortly. But as before, you just need to get your paint ready and get that good tip on your brush. And well, we'll start by painting the loincloth just down here. So as before, we want to pick out the most raised areas, and a lot of those in this case will be around the edge. So what you want to do is just follow all the way around the outside like that and along the bottom as well. Now you can see how smooth it is on that curve just there for the fabric, but still I want to get the most raised parts, which you can see follows that crease down there like that. So for highlighting these sorts of things, all I'm going to do is follow that edge just down there like that. I've finished highlighting with White Scar now, and you can see I also highlighted that white collar and the bandana by once again picking out all the edges and most raised parts of the creases. And with that done, we're now ready for the next highlight, and this is going to be Gorthor Brown for all the brown leather. Now the technique here is much the same, so I'm still going to be using my small airbrush to apply this colour, and again I'm going to use the palette to get the paint ready. Only this time there are some parts where you've really got to hold your hand steady, so again we'll show you that in just a moment. So once the paint is ready, and we've got that good tip on the brush, a great example of somewhere where you've got to be really careful is on that leather strap we've got just going across the chest there. So you can see I just need to brace my hands as steady as possible, and then just very gently follow that edge all the way up like this to get that highlight there. And you also want to pick out these little circles, these little holes we've got in the leather just there. Now another detail to pick out at this point is all the stuff around the belt, so don't forget to do these details as well. We've now finished painting all the brown leather, so we can now move on to highlighting the remaining details. Now the technique we're going to use is the same as what we've been using so far, so what we're going to do now is run through these remaining colours for you quickly. First of all, we need Stormhost Silver to highlight all the silver details, and then we're going to move on to highlighting all the black details. Now because there's quite a lot of black on this miniature, what we're going to do is use two different highlights to separate them into two different textures for a bit more variety and interest really on the miniature. So first of all, we're going to need Dark Reaper, and this will be for the jacket and the trousers, but then we're going to use Skavenblight Dinge to highlight all the remaining black detail. Finally, we're going to need Ushabti Bone, and this is to highlight the hair. But first of all, we're going to use Stormhost Silver, and again I'm using my small airbrush because I want to pick out all those sharpest edges and details using this colour, so you need lots of control again. So use your palette to help get that ready. A little bit of water mixed in there, and now we're ready to start picking this detail out. So I'm going to start on the shotgun just on here, picking out the magazine by just lightly running it along the edge like that for a nice sharp highlight. You just repeat this technique across all the silver details. But as you're doing this, just watch out for any really small silver parts. For example, we've got just a little stud here just on the side of this satchel, so on this point I can just pick that out there really carefully like that. We're now ready to begin highlighting all the black details, and first of all we need Dark Reaper. Now this is for the jacket and the trousers only, so the softer bits of fabric really. And again you want to go around all the edges, and you also want to look for the raised areas of creases too. So for example on the trousers you can see we've got some creases just at the back here. What I'm going to do is just paint a line of this colour following on all the tops of each of these creases of fabric. Then highlight all the remaining black details using Skavenblight Dinge, and this will create a subtle difference in texture between the two different sorts of black that we've now painted onto the miniature. And finally, we need Ushabti Bone to highlight the hair. For this, what you need to do is just paint on all the raised strands just following along them with a fine bit of this colour like this. And with those highlights applied, our House Orlock Ganger is looking great. However, at this stage, if you want to, you can make those black details stand out a little bit more by adding a second highlight to the two different tones that we've got. Now, if you choose to do this, what you'll need is Fenrisian Grey, first of all, followed by Administratum Grey. And you'll also need the very smallest brush you've got, so I'm going to use an extra small artificial layer brush. We're going to be beginning with Fenrisian Grey, however, first of all, and this is going to be for all those fabric details that we picked out with Dark Reaper earlier on. So you're looking at the jacket and also the trousers too. And you really don't need very much of this, and you also want it to be quite runny. If you look carefully here, you can see I've thinned it down with a bit more water than I have been doing recently, so it's quite transparent when I paint it on the white of the palette just there. And I'm making sure I've only got a small amount of my brush. And what we want to do is paint a small bit of this colour on the very sharpest details of these black parts we did with Dark Reaper. So if I start on the jacket, for example, see you've got that little point there near the collar, all I'm going to do is add a very small amount of this colour just there like that, just a very fine sharp highlight just to make that detail pop out a little bit more. So I'll do the same on the other side, and all the time just looking for little sharper areas like this, just to pick out in this way. And with that done, we're now ready to highlight all the remaining black details using Administratum Grey. And this is the exact same technique, so for example on the shoulder plate, I'm looking for the corner just here, I'm just going to paint a very small amount of this colour there like that to help it pop out a little bit more. Then I'll be doing exactly the same on all these black details, such as the shotgun, by highlighting corners such as just here. And with those highlights applied, we now just have one more detail to add to the miniature to finish it off, and that is to add some rust to his armour. Now, if you want to do this, what you need is Scrag Brown and your small layer brush, and what we're going to do is create a very thin version of this paint on the palette. So just get a small amount on there like that, and then get lots of water and really, really water it down. So you want it very thin, kind of like this. You can see just how runny it is. And then, very importantly, make sure you don't overload your brush, because when you put a lot of this on, it's easy to let it run out of control, and you want to avoid that. So instead, just make sure you've got a small amount loaded on your brush, and then all you do is start randomly painting this onto the metal details of your miniature. So if I look at this metal plate we got on the back of the hand there, all I do is just run some of this on, and we get a really nice rust effect really easily. Now, once you've done this, your miniature is complete and just needs to be based. And as always, I recommend you base your miniature in the same way as the rest of your gang. And with the base fully painted, this House Orlock Ganger is complete, ready to join his fellow Sump Dogs and take on his enemies in the Underhive. So when you're painting this Citadel miniature, and in fact with any Citadel miniature, there's a couple of important things to remember. The first is that we always recommend that you use a palette, because doing so allows you to thin your paint down with a little bit of water and get much more control over it by making sure that your brush isn't overloaded. Now also, there was a time when we used some shade over a small select area, which was his skin. When you're using shade like this, always be careful not to put on too much at once, because it's easy to lose control of it and get it onto details where you don't want it. Finally, as always, neatness is the key. The neater you are, the better your miniature is going to look, especially when you're adding those final highlights. So there you go. Now we really hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and we really hope you've learned something from it. And well, have fun painting your House Orlock Gang, and have fun playing with them as well. And we'll see you all again very soon.